Hello and welcome to this special virtual program brought to you by your friends at the Tulsa City County Library. My name is Mike Schneider, so glad to be with you here today. And you know, I've been there many times in the past for kids programs at the library, but today it's your turn. You get a special program on the history of polka music. And we're going to get started appropriately with a song called Hello.
Someone you don't know that passes. Hello, hello, hello. What a wonderful word, hello.
Off. And I'll be right back in just a moment with some information on how this accordion actually works.
This program is brought to you by the Tulsa City County Library.
And I'm back right now to let you know a little bit about how this instrument actually works. And you know, a question that I ask during almost every one of the pint-sized polkas programs that I do is, what do you call this instrument? Sometimes I'll get someone who says, it's a harmonica. Everybody laughs, they think it's funny, but they don't realize just how close to right the person who said harmonica actually is. And here's why. If we open up this accordion right now, we'll see inside a series of reed blocks. The reed blocks, they look kind of like big harmonicas, and they operate like harmonicas too. When I blow through this harmonica, that's how I get sound out of the harmonica. How do I get sound out of the accordion? I can't blow through the reeds, can't blow through the reed blocks, but I can use the bellows to move air in and out of the instrument. How do I tell the accordion which note I want it to play? Well, I can push one of these keys, and when I push this key, it opens up a little hole in the accordion. Through that hole, air is able to travel to the reed and makes the reed vibrate. That is how you make music with an accordion. So now that you know how the accordion works, let's take a closer look at the history of the instrument.
Today's accordion is based on an instrument called the shang, which is a mouth-blown free reed instrument. Similar to the accordion, sound is produced by air moving across the reed, causing it to vibrate. The shang was developed in China nearly 4,500 years ago, which is around the time that skis were invented. The modern accordion began to take shape in the early 1800s, particularly in Paris, France. Accordions at that time had buttons on both sides and used diatonic button boards to produce the melody, rather than the piano keys used on most modern accordions. The accordion was a popular instrument because of its portability and affordable price. But it wasn't mass-produced until Paolo Soprani discovered the accordion and improved its design in 1863 in his hometown of Castelfidardo, Italy, which remains today as the accordion manufacturing capital of the world. Two world wars affected accordion production in Italy, but the instrument's popularity remained thanks to musicians like Pietro Diario, Charles Magnante, and later, Dick Contino.
And, you know, another important figure in the history of the accordion and of polka music is a guy by the name of Lawrence Swelk. I'm sure you've heard of him, sure you're familiar with his TV show, probably watched it whether you wanted to or not, but I'm going to do a song that he wrote right now that was played really well by his accordion player Myron Florin. This is called the Champagne Polka. Polka, as written by the late, great Lawrence Swelk. Time right now for a special edition of Name That Tune. The way it works is I will play three short polka songs for you. At the end, I'll give you the answers. We'll test your knowledge on polka music. Here comes mystery song number one. All right, mystery song number one there. The answer coming up in just a moment. Here comes mystery song number two, and I'm going to give you a clue for this one. Since this one's a little tougher, think of a state. Mystery song number two, named after a state. You have a couple of seconds to think about that. In the meantime, here comes our third and final mystery tune, and your clue for this one is, this was a million seller. Your third and final mystery tune, and right now it's time to reveal the answers. Mystery song number one was the Beer Barrel Polka, also known as Roll Out the Barrel. Mystery song number two, I said, think of a state. I hope you thought of Pennsylvania, the Pennsylvania Polka. And our third and final mystery tune is a song called Just Because. Yes, and that was a million seller for Frankie Yankovic way back in the late 1940s. And I have a little trivia question for you right now that goes along with that fact. And the question is, a million seller for Frankie Yankovic Just Because was covered also by which of the following artists? Your four multiple choices are either A, Paul McCartney, B, Elvis Presley, C, both, or D, neither. Ooh, what do you think about that one? Well, here comes the answer, and it is C for both. Yes, both Paul McCartney and Elvis Presley covered Just Because. Some pretty impressive times for polka music starting there in the late 1940s. And what do you say right now we learn a little bit about the history of polka music?
Polka music began in Eastern Europe in the 1800s. Becoming popular in the ballrooms of Prague, Czech Republic by 1835, spreading to Vienna, Austria in 1839, and then to Paris, France in 1840. The polka dance craze quickly spread throughout Europe. By way of immigration, polka found its way to the United States. Immigrants from Poland settled in places like Chicago, Illinois. Slovenian immigrants made Cleveland, Ohio their home. German immigrants moved to cities like Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Each of these cities would become known for their polka music. Polka music gained mainstream appeal in the late 1940s, thanks in large part to Frankie Yankovic's two platinum albums, Just Because Polka, and Blue Skirt Waltz. In 1948, Yankovic was awarded the title of America's Polka King at the Milwaukee Arena in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, where he would later beat Duke Ellington in a Battle of the Bands competition. Yankovic's lengthy career in polka music was capped off in 1986 with the first ever Grammy Award for Best Polka Album. Since that time, Jimmy Sturr has assumed the role of modern-era polka king, earning 5 gold albums and 18 Grammy Awards in the polka category, surpassing the likes of Ray Charles, Leonard Bernstein, and Ella Fitzgerald. The polka category was eliminated from the Grammy Awards in 2009. Polka music with European roots has also influenced other forms of music. During the Mexican Revolution from 1910 to 1917, Germans who had moved to Mexico were forced to flee to South Texas, where their style of polka music and instrument of choice, the accordion, inspired Hispanic musicians like Flaco Jimenez to create the Tejano form of music in the 1940s.
And as you could probably tell, Frankie Yankovic factors very large into the history of polka music here in the United States. He also factors pretty heavily in my history as a polka musician. You know, my dad, when I was 2 or 3 years old, he'd bring his accordion out from time to time. He played the accordion, kind of planted those early seeds of polka music. And then when I was 5 years old, my parents took me to hear Frankie Yankovic play. And from that day forward, I just had to play the accordion, I had to play polka music, and I've been doing it professionally now since 1996, doing this program, my pint-sized polkas program for kids, and also these programs for adults since 2008, and this year doing my very first virtual programs. I hope you are enjoying this one. Well, you know, one of the songs I remember most from the first time that I heard Frankie Yankovic play is the Happy Wanderer Polka. Valderie, Valdera, if you feel like singing along at home, you're not at the library, you can be as loud as you want. Here we go, the Happy Wanderer.
I loved singing the Wanderer along the mountain track. And as I go, I love to sing my knapsack on my back. Valderie, Valdera, Valderie, Valdera, Valderie, Valdera, my knapsack on my back. I love to wander by the stream that dances in the sun. So joyously it calls to me, come join my happy song. Valderie, Valdera, Valderie, Valdera, Valderie, Valdera, come join my happy song. Oh, may I go on wandering until the day I die. And may I always laugh and sing beneath God's clear blue sky.
One more time.
Valderie, Valdera, Valderie, Valdera, Valderie, Valdera, beneath God's clear blue sky. God's clear blue sky.
The Happy Wanderer Polka. I'll be right back.
Visit MikeSchneiderBand.com for a complete schedule of events. While you're there, check out the media and music pages for videos and to purchase music from the Mike Schneider Band.
Back right now to finish the rest of a song I started during Name That Tune. This is one of Frankie Yankovic's 2 million sellers called Just Because.
Just because you think you're so pretty, just because you think you're so hot, just because you think you got something that no somebody else has got. Now you cause me to spend all my money. You laugh and call me old Santa Claus. I'm telling you, baby, I'm through with you just because. Just because. Just because you think you're so pretty, just because you think you're so hot, just because you think you got something that nobody else has got. You cause me to spend all my money. You laugh and call me old Santa Claus. I'm telling you, baby, I'm through with you just because. Just because.
Just because. And you know, 1 million seller deserves another, so we'll go from Just Because to the Blue Skirt Waltz, another one of Frank Yankovic's gold albums from the late 1940s.
I wandered alone one night till I heard an orchestra play. I met you where lights were bright and people were carefree that day. You were the beautiful lady in blue. I was in heaven just waltzing with you. You thrilled me with strange delight till softly you stole away. I dream of that night with you, lady, when first we met. We danced in a world of blue. How can my heart forget? Blue were the skies and blue were your eyes, just like the blue skirt you wore. Come back, blue lady, come back. Don't be blue anymore. I dream of that night with you, lady, when first we met. We danced in a world of blue. How can my heart forget? Blue were the skies and blue were your eyes, just like the blue skirt you wore. Come back, blue lady, come back. Don't be blue anymore. Thank you.
waltz, and I'll be right back with our final song of the day.
This program is brought to you by the Tulsa City County Library.
And thank you once again to the Tulsa City County Library for having me do this special virtual program on the history of polka music. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, make sure to thank a librarian. Well, we're going to wrap up with our final song of the day today. And, I did it earlier, did part of it earlier during Name That Tune. We'll finish it off right now. Do Roll Out the Barrel, the Beer Barrel Polka, and a little medley with EIO. Thanks again for tuning in, and sing along.
Roll out the barrel, we'll have a barrel of fun. Roll out the barrel, we've got the blues on the run. Zane Boonsomero, ring out a song of good cheer. Now's the time to roll the barrel, for the game's all here.
If you know the words, sing along. Roll out the barrel.
Roll out the barrel. We'll have a barrel of fun. Roll out the barrel. We've got the blues on the run. Zane Boonsomero, ring out a song of good cheer. Now's the time to roll the barrel, for the gang's all here. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Saying thank you again for watching, and please visit my website at MikeSchneiderBand.com to purchase my CDs and for more information. I hope to see you back at your library real soon. In the meantime, thanks again and stay healthy.
Stop the credits for this important trivia question. This popular polka song made its U.S. debut in Tulsa, Oklahoma, in 1981. Your three multiple choices are A, The Chicken Dance, B, In Heaven There Is No Beer, or C, Who Stole the Kishka? If you guessed A for The Chicken Dance, you are correct. The Chicken Dance was originally called The Duck Dance in Germany, but no one could find a duck costume in Tulsa. However, a chicken costume was secured, and The Chicken Dance was born. Stay tuned to my Pint-Sized Polkas program for the Tulsa City County Libraries for more chicken dance fun. In the meantime, here's a clip. Enjoy the chicken dance.
Let's get started.
First you make your little beaks, and you flap your little wings, and you wiggle all the way down to the ground. You do it once again, just pretend that you're a hen. You'll be the best dancer in town. This isn't just a dance, it is called the chicken dance. It is the greatest dance around. You give it just one chance, it is worth a second glance. You'll be amazed at what you find.
Now, Evan and Kelby, I need the two of you to face each other. Yep, and I need you both to put out just your right chicken wing. Yeah, and now I need you to take those chicken wings and link your chicken wings together. And now I need the two of you to twirl around safely. If you have a partner there at home, twirl around safely with them. Otherwise, twirl around safely by yourself. Here we go.
Now go and find yourself a partner as you twirl around the floor. And once you've done the chicken dance, you'll keep coming back for more.
Here we go again with the chicken dance part. Clap, 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 clap. Ooh, ooh, Evan and Kelby, do you suppose you could go faster?
Yes.
Yes, all right, I hope you're ready to go faster at home. Here we go. Find a partner and twirl around. The chicken dance.
Now here are your credits, already in progress.